This is the second tutorial on how to do prime factoring. Let's review. The definition is that a number's prime factors are the prime numbers that multiplied together give the number. The tools you need to do prime factoring are to know some tricks and to know the first few prime numbers. Let's review. The first few prime numbers, those less than 20, are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, and 19. Now in the first tutorial we learned some tricks for how to find out if a number is divisible by 2, by 3, or by 5. Here we'll learn some additional tricks. The first one is that a number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by both 2 and by 3. In other words, if its last digit is even, and if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. Another trick is that a number is divisible by 9 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 9. So for instance, the number 207 has the sum of its digits 2 plus 0 plus 7 equal to 9, which is divisible by 9. Therefore, 207 is divisible by 9. Finally, a number is divisible by 10 if it ends in a 0. Let's do an example. Let's find the prime factors of the number 2430. First of all, 2430 ends in a 0. Therefore, it is divisible by 10. 2430 is equal to 10 times 243, and because 10 can be written in terms of its prime factors as 2 times 5, we can write 2430 as 2 times 5 times 243. 243 is not prime. The sum of its digits is 2 plus 4 plus 3 equals 9. Therefore, 243 is divisible both by 3 and by 9. You can easily show that 243 is equal to 3 times 81. 81 is a perfect square. 81 is equal to 9 times 9, or in other words, in terms of its prime factors, 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Therefore, we have our final answer. The number 2430 is equal to 2 times 5 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3.